Okay, well, here we are at box number two, and I wanted to show you what all you get in the second box. I opened up the third box. There was a third box, and I went ahead and opened it, and what was in it was the shallow wax, and that's a I got the video from Penn State Industries, and they have a video that shows you how to use the equipment, how to do a pen, and I believe they use this shallow wax on the last step to really buff down the wood, and I was really impressed with that. It really did a nice job, so I'm glad that came with it, because I'm excited to try that, see how well it works. So that was in the box. That's all that was in that little box. And box number two here, which was the bigger box, you get a magazine, Penn State Industries. I have to say, I'm really impressed. I don't know about the other companies out there, and if they watch this, nothing against you. I don't know what all you guys offer. I've seen some of the websites. It looks like you got a lot of nice stuff. This here came with a catalog, and it just has all kinds of stuff, blanks, and has different items that you can make, and I'm excited. I can't wait to start doing some of this stuff. I mean, razors and all kinds of just super neat pens. I can't wait to really get into that. That's so neat. You have your gouge here, your carbide gouge, which comes with it. It's a small one. I've seen bigger ones that you can lay up against you. So you get this. I bought a different type that's more expensive, and it has like a tip on it that's round, and it's a blade, and you don't have sharp in it. And whenever you use it and it starts getting dull, you just turn it a little bit. You can keep using it. Those sell for about 90 bucks. Then once they go dull, you just go out and buy another blade for $20, I guess, is how much they are. These here you have to sharpen. I'm going to give this a try. I talked to a guy today that he makes pens, a lot of pens, and he uses one like this. And he was showing me how you sharpen them. So I may try this, just see how it works. He seemed to like this better than what the other tool is, even though it's more expensive. So, but you have to get these on just the right angle in order to get that sharpened so it works. And I believe you have to sharpen this more often than what you do the other one. So, but we'll give that a try, see how that works. You get your abrasive roll, multi-pack. You get 150 grit, 240, 320, 400, and 600, which is nice. You get your pen blanks. They're already pre-drilled, and you get that's a 20 pack, so you can do all your pens that you get. Here's the packets that you get. This one here is a chrome-plated Funline pen kit. You get five pens. Here's a 24 karat gold-plated Funline kit. You get five pens in there. Now I went ahead. I use pencils more than I do pens, so I wanted to get a couple pencil kits, and they had these. I forget why I paid for them. I think it was like, I don't know, $4 or $5, something like that, for the pencils. So probably the first ones I do, if they come out looking good, I'll probably make me a pencil with that. You get the CA glue, pen maker CA. You also get a pen tube insertion tool. These are nice, so you don't get glue all over your hands. I've seen other people that, actually, whenever I was taking the class, there was a couple of people got their fingers kind of glued together, because rather than using one of these, they just put the glue on the insert, put it in, and they got a little bit of glue on their fingers. At least this way, you can put the insert on there, put the glue on, stick it in, and keep from getting all glued up. These don't come with it. These are finishing pads. I bought these extra because I want to do acrylic blanks, and I heard that these are good for acrylic blanks. You get them wet and you go through the different colors to do that. So I wanted to get a set of those. They're not real expensive. Forget exactly why I paid for them, but I figured I'd have to buy them eventually anyway, so I went ahead and got those along with it. You also get your barrel trimmer. This is a 7mm barrel trimmer, and this is so that you can trim the ends of your blanks so that they're flush, and the inside, or this tube here, goes down into the barrel and it cleans out the inside in case any glue gets in there, keeps it nice and smooth. And then this here, which is the pin press, it's actually almost heavier than what the lathe is, but you can press the pins with several things. I've seen people on YouTube use clamps, the hand clamps that you squeeze together, vices. I've seen wood vices that's on your benches. You can use that. When I was taking the class, we used one of these. It seemed like once you got the adjustment here for the length, it pretty much was you just set up there, press it, and it's done. It worked pretty smooth. And I don't believe once you get one of these, seeing how you don't use it, except pressing them together, I would think they'd last a pretty long time. So it was nice it came with the kit. That way I don't have to buy one down the road. And for the price of the whole outfit, is worth it. So anyway, that's why it comes in the second box. And you're pretty much set to go. I mean, I bought a drill press. Got one from Harbor Freight. And you can get coupons, 20-25% off. And I just bought a small one. Hopefully that'll work well enough. These are just small pieces of wood. Seriously, I mean, why is that? Probably 2 inches, 2.5 inches, something like that. So I would think that'd be more than enough to do the wood. And we'll see how that works. But really, you pretty much are set to go whenever you get this kit. And I would think you'd be making pins. I'm going to try making a pin today, actually. So if I get a chance, I might even film it as well so you can see how the lathe works. So anyway, that's the Pin Station Industries Penpal kit. Again, I haven't seen anything on YouTube about this, and I wanted to kind of show everybody what this one looked like. Hopefully this will help somebody out.